Breaking news, Anambra 2021, release Nnamdi Kanu, withdraw military immediately, candidate tells Buhari. The news details. It has been reported that 9 candidates in the forthcoming Anambra governorship election have demanded for the release of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Mercy Nnamdi Kanu, from the federal government. In a statement jointly signed by Ben Etiaba, the AA candidates Charles Soludo, Habga, Obinna Uzo, SDP, Akachukwu Nwankpo, ADC, Onyejegbu Okwedilu, APM, Ifeanyi Uba, YPP, Andy Uba, APC, Nnamdi Nnamwo, PLP, and Obiora Okonkwo of the ZLP also urged the federal government to demilitarize the Southeast zone in a bid to stem the heightened tension in the area. We, the candidates in the forthcoming Anambra State governorship election, commit unequivocally to non-violence and the maintenance of peace throughout the duration of the election and beyond. We urge all our supporters and other stakeholders to commit fully to these ideals and refrain from any act that may imperil the election in order to eschew all acts that may torpedo the forthcoming election. We urge the federal government to release Mercy Nnamdi Kanu to the Southeast Council of Traditional Rulers and representatives of Igbo archbishops and bishops. We urge the federal government to take urgent steps to demilitarize the Southeast zone and stem the heightened tension, skirmishes, and endless bloodletting between the security agencies and our youths. We urge IPOB not to do anything that will hinder or be seen to be injuring the smooth running of the forthcoming governorship election in Anambra State, and to cancel all scheduled sit-at-home orders, as these have already caused untold hardship for our people. We call on the Independent National Electoral Commission, the armed forces, other security agencies, and all stakeholders to discharge their mandates in accordance with law and in a fair and just manner, the statement reads. The 9 candidates of the Anambra gubernatorial election and make some demands from the federal government that the federal government should release Mercy Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, prior to the Anambra gubernatorial election that is going to hold November 6, 2021. Said the leader should be released if that will cause peace in the region. And also, they're demanding that the federal government should demilitarize the Southeast region. The militaries are too much and they are doing what they are not supposed to do. They are opening fire to the youth in the region. And this is not supposed to be so. The military are too much for the region. They are also causing death and a lot of things. Billions of dollars has gone down the drain. A lot of lives have gone. What is now the essence? When you know that the only solution to all these atrocities is by releasing the IPOB leader. And they are admonishing the IPOB to please cancel all orders, as they have created fears in the hearts of these people not to come and vote. They should allow these people to vote and also cancel their 1 week sit at home order, so people can be free. The federal government should release Mercy Nnamdi Kanu if he wants peace to reign in the Southeast region, because it is only Mercy Nnamdi Kanu the people listen to. They don't listen to other people, but only their leader. The Anambra APC, PDP, and APGA governorship candidates agree on dialogue with IPOB. The Anambra State governorship candidates of the All Progressives Party and the UBA, the All Progressives Grand Alliance, Chukwuma Soludo, and Valentine Osigbo of the People's Democratic Party, have expressed their views about the agitations and the tension of the indigenous people of Biafra. According to Osigbo, the people candidate, PDP candidate, Kanu, the detained IPOB leader, was a product of leadership failure. Roy Soludo said dialogue is the best solution to the IPOB issue, noting that IPOB deserves to be had. Dialogue, he said. These candidates are all coming up. They know that the Anambra election is so important to them, and if they want this election to hold, Nnamdi Kanu needs to be released and they must dialogue with Nnamdi Kanu. So, my people, what do you say concerning this news? What's your take on this news? Please feel free to share your take. Thank you and enjoy the rest of your day.